Hi, welcome to the channel. My name's Emma. This is Destination FBA and I upload regular videos to offer advice, support to those who sell on Amazon. Now, I've also just launched my brand new course, The Ultimate Beginner's Guide to Online Arbitrage, which you can find in the description below. Now, for a short time only, I'm offering a 66% discount to beta testers for this. So what this means is instead of the normal price of £299, you will pay just £99. So as I said, the description is in the link below and you just need to use code BETA10 to get your discount. So today I want to talk to you about VAT and what this means for our business. So VAT is value added tax, and for most goods and services in the UK, this is set at 20%. Now, once you set up your seller account and you start making sales, you'll be charged VAT on most of the fees you're paying. So these fees are things like your fulfillment fees, your storage fees, and your listing fees. Now, you can avoid paying these fees if you're not VAT registered. And this is because most of the invoices from Amazon actually come from Amazon Luxembourg and not Amazon UK. Now, this is something most sellers aren't aware of, but it can make a really big difference to how much money you make, how profitable you are as a business. All you need to do is declare that exemption to Amazon. So as things stand right now, you don't legally have to register for VAT until you reach that VAT threshold. Now, this is currently set at £85,000 of taxable turnover in a 12-month period. So if your sales are below that £85,000, you don't need to worry about registering just yet unless you expect to hit that threshold within the next 30 days. Now, you can voluntarily register sooner if you want to, but this may not be in your best interest financially. So yes, you'll be able to claim the VAT back on all those business expenses, but you will also have to pay VAT on all your sales. This would almost certainly make you less competitive, especially if your competition is not VAT registered. Now, if you're not sure which way to go, I would say just make sure you get advice from a tax advisor or from your own accountant. So going back to selling on Amazon, if you choose to not register, which I imagine is the case for most, if not all of you, then you need to declare this to Amazon as soon as you set up that seller account. This will just make sure they do not charge you VAT on all those selling fees. So this will save you a lot of money and it's really going to help to increase those profit margins as well. Now, if you've been selling for a while already and you didn't know about that exemption, don't worry, you can declare exemption at any point and you can even claim back those overpaid fees as well. So I did this myself about 2.5 years ago. I claimed back around £3,000. So I will show you exactly how you can do this in the next video. So to request that exemption, you're going to need to open a case with Amazon. So I've created a template. You're more than welcome to use this for it. So it just simply reads, "Hi, I'm writing to request that our business be registered as VAT exempt and granted VAT exemption on our seller fees. We are currently selling on the UK marketplace and want to ensure that we are fully compliant with VAT regulations and be sure we are not unnecessarily incurring VAT costs. Our business operates as a sole trader or a limited company, and I have included our certificate of incorporation or our UTR number for your reference. Our current annual turnover is below the VAT threshold of £85,000, meaning we are not legally required to be VAT registered. We would like to take steps to ensure our business is structured in the most financially efficient manner as possible and would greatly appreciate any assistance with this matter. Please do let me know if you require any further information or documentation from us." So to open the case, you just need to log into your Seller Central account, go up to that help button at the top right of the page, and then scroll down, click where it says, "Need more help, get support." Now from here, just click sell on Amazon and then you'll be able to copy and paste in the template. Just be sure you enter your business name and you let them know which documentation you've provided. Now you can then click continue, my issue is not listed, and then choose account related before clicking continue at the bottom. So I heard back from Amazon myself very quickly. In fact, it was within 48 hours. They added that exemption to my account immediately. So I'll just show you the reply I got from them, though this will be slightly different to what you'll get because I was also requesting a refund on those fees. "Dear seller, thank you for contacting Amazon Selling Partner Support. I understand you wish to be VAT exempt on seller fees and request for VAT refund. Thank you for providing the required documents. Upon reviewing the same, our team has concluded the following. As of 9th of July 2021, you will be exempt from paying VAT on seller fees. You may review the same in your tax document library once your June seller fee invoices are available to view and download." So applying for that exemption really took no time at all, and for what it's going to save you in fees, I would recommend you do this as soon as you possibly can. Just taking a few minutes to do this will make you more competitive on that pricing. It's going to mean you're making more profits overall. Now, once you've done that, I'd also recommend you take a look at automated invoicing so you don't have to worry about your invoice defect rate. Having to send invoices to business customers and having to do it within 24 hours can be really time consuming. So you're best to let Amazon do as much of the work as possible, giving you more time to spend in other areas of the business. So if you go to Sell Central and just type invoice defect rate at the top here, and then you'll get this pop out along the right hand side. Just click there and then scroll all the way down to number 8. So we've got invoice receipt generated by Amazon, and then within option B, if you are exempt from VAT registration in both the EU and the UK and meet the terms and conditions, declare your VAT exemption status and let Amazon generate receipts on your behalf at no cost. So just click that link that says declare your VAT exemption, and you'll be taken to this page here where you can declare your status. Now, as you can see, this is already set up on my account along with the automated receipt generation as well. Now, if at any point in the future you're no longer exempt, you need to make sure you withdraw this status, and you can do this just at the bottom of the page. This will also mean you're the one now responsible for sending those invoices to your business customers directly. Now, if you've already gone through this process, you've managed to successfully register, or you managed to successfully do it after watching this video, please do let me know below. Now, we'll do another video as well, where we talk about claiming back those overpaid fees if you had absolutely no idea of that VAT exemption. Any questions at all, please do pop a comment below, jump over in our Facebook group, I will do whatever I can to help you out. Now also, if you're brand new to selling on Amazon, you still need a bit of guidance, a bit of support, don't forget that link to the course in the description below. So this is my new course, The Ultimate Beginner's Guide to Online Arbitrage, and there's still time for you to jump in if you're quick, get on as a beta tester, it receives 66% discount. So code BETA10 when you sign up, you can get this for just £99 instead of £299. Now thank you as always for watching, take care, and I will see you in the next video.